In today's video, I'm going to show you the first steps to install a chroot environment with Ubuntu on our Android device and be able to run a desktop like XFC4. I have pinning to make scripts to launch the environments automatically as with Prut or Termix, but I have not had much time, so at least I show you how to configure chroot in a more manual way. Keep in mind that this whole process is tricky as we will have root permissions in Termix, and we can delete and touch system files if we don't know what we are doing, so the device could be bricked. Keep this in mind and learn about the steps we are doing. I recommend to always have everything ready to flash again the ROM of the device if something happens so you don't panic and know that you can recover everything. I have left all the steps written in my GitHub repository, and I leave links to the blogs I have based on, mainly Yvonne's blog. If you have any problem, you can leave it in the comments. As I said, all the steps are in my repository, so let's go directly. As requirements, we have to be root because we are going to install the chroot environment, and we have to have Magisk installed because we need to install the module called BusyBox. To install it, we simply go to the repository link, download the latest version, and proceed to install it for Magisk. To install modules from Magisk, we have to open the application and go to the modules section. There we will select Install and the file that we have downloaded previously. When the process is finished, click on the Reboot button to reboot the device. Once the device is rebooted, we can reopen the repository with the instructions and start installing everything we need in Termix. First, we install the packages that I have left in the First Steps section. Then we go to the section on how to configure the environment, and we copy commands step by step. We create the necessary folders for the chroot system in a separate folder in case we want to delete it in the future. That is easy to do. We download the system we are going to use, in this case Ubuntu. We unzip the file and check that all the necessary folders appear. Now we are going to create a script to mount the chroot environment and enter the distribution we have installed, that is, Ubuntu. As you can see, I have not been able to use Nano on my tablet, although on another device I could. Instead, we are going to use Vim, which is a bit more confusing the first time you use it. We press the A or I key to enter edit mode in Vim and paste the contents of the script. Exit Vim with the combination Ctrl plus C and type colon W, Q, and hit enter. We check that the content has been copied well. In my case, I made a mistake, and in the upper part, some characters are missing, but I fixed it later. We give permissions of execution to the script, and we execute it. I have made a cut for the error that I have commented previously that I was missing some characters of the script when copying it. Now we will see that the prompt has changed and appears root and localhost. This means that we are now inside our Ubuntu distribution in chroot. We proceed to configure the distribution with the commands from the repository. We configure the time zone. And let's create a user called DroidMaster, so we don't have to use the root user for everything. We give super user permissions to the newly created user. This process is similar to the chroot environments. we only have to copy the line below it for the root user. We finish configuring the distribution and finally we install the graphical desktop environment. In this case, we are going to install XFC4 since it is the one that worked correctly for me. We disable Snapped, as it is not compatible with Android, unfortunately. Next, we are going to prepare everything to launch the graphical environment. We run the command you see on the screen from Termix already outside the chroot environment and outside the superuser permissions. We start the X11 session. As we can see in the Termix X11 application, and the black screen appears indicating that it has started. Now we get back into chroot as you see in the video, and we will execute the commands you see on the screen. Finally, we launch the XFC4 desktop with the command, and if we go to Termix X11, we can use it normally. To configure XFC4, I leave a video below in the description. I'm still testing and I want to automate the start of the chroot environment, but I hope you like the video and subscribe if you're not because it helps a lot to the channel. I have pending to test with other distributions and upload videos about it, so stay tuned to the channel.